guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be a semi-vlog and a baking video because last night I just couldn't stop craving pizza for some reason. I really wanted pizza and I've been making a lot of chicken tikka pizza these days at home. They've been becoming very, very good. So I thought I'll share with you guys how I make my own pizza at home. And this time I'm gonna do paneer because I kind of want that. I thought I'll take you guys first to show you guys what all the things are that I'm purchasing for making this pizza, because I do have processed cheese. However, I wanted mozzarella because you do not eat pizza without mozzarella cheese. That is one thing, and I think I also need yeast. My yeast is almost old. So let's go out and maybe we'll have a cup of coffee or tea, and I thought I'll take you guys along. So let's get going. So now that we have done our shopping, I want to go ahead and show you how I make my pizza at home. Now, when it comes to making pizza at home, I make sure that I make the dough, the pizza sauce, and also the toppings as and how I like, so that I can customize it and it tastes just like I would like it. So today I'm going to show you guys all these three things. And like I already mentioned, I'll be making a paneer pizza. And for starters, I'm going to show you guys how I make my dough. I've been making pizza at home for quite some time now because of quarantine, maybe because earlier we used to go out, but now I kind of mastered the way to do a pizza. So I thought I'll share it with you guys. Let me get started and I'll show you guys how to make the pizza dough first. Now that the dough is made, it's not completed because it needs time to rest and for the yeast to activate. So I'm going to keep it aside for at least 2 hours. In the meanwhile, I'm going to show you guys how to make the pizza sauce. So the first thing I'm going to use is half an onion. I'm going to remove the eye of the onion first. I'm going to just remove the eye of the tomatoes. And here I'm using about 5 ripe tomatoes. I'm just going to halve these tomatoes. We don't really have to cut them into cubes or chunks. So I'm going to just leave them halved. Now that our pan is hot, I'm going to use oil. You can use any kind of oil. I'm using a normal sunflower oil. It does not overpower anything. And I'm going to go ahead and pour the oil here to heat it up first. Now that our oil is hot, I'm going to add around 8 small cloves of garlic. Now, making your own sauce also means that you can customize it as and how you require. So I wouldn't say you should skip this part because it does give you a nice flavor, but you can obviously reduce it. And if you also want, you can definitely skip it. But I would strongly recommend that you put this in. I'm also adding in half the onion. And I'm going to saute it for about 2 minutes now. Now that our onion and garlic is getting sauteed, I'm going to talk to you about the seasonings which we use for this particular sauce. The three most important things which you could use on a pizza sauce would be oregano, basil, and dried red chili. So these are the three flakes which you really require. These are all dried spices which can be added to give an Italian taste to the sauce. But here for me, I only have oregano and chili flakes. I don't have basil. That can be optional, because I've tried it only with this and that works fine. That's why I don't have basil with me. But even if you don't have all of this with you, you can also get a mixed spice. I think it's called as mixed pizza herbs, I'm not sure. For chili flakes, I make it with the dried chili I have at home. I don't really purchase and keep it handy. And if you have anything extra left, you can store this in an airtight container in your fridge and it'll stay up to 3 weeks. So no problem there. Now this chili is made at home and this is very spicy, so I'm going to use only half a small spoon. Now again, this depends on how much spice you require, and I'm going to use 1 spoon of dried oregano. Now let this saute for a minute, after which we will be adding our tomatoes in. As soon as I added the chili flakes and the oregano, my house started smelling like Italy, if you may say. Now, I've only halved these tomatoes and I'm going to add it as it is because I want to remove the skin of these tomatoes, and I'll show you how I do that. At this point, I'm also going to add in some salt to taste. I'm going to turn all of these upside down. I'm going to cover this and cook this for 10 minutes. At this time, I'm going to prepare the paneer. I'm going to marinate it for some time before I fry them. So let's get doing that. I'm cutting the paneer into cubes or as I require to add to the pizza. So I have cubed these paneer small as I require for the toppings. It depends totally up to you on how you want to size these paneer cubes. Now for the marinade, I'm going to take 1 spoon of thick yogurt, little salt to taste, half a spoon of Kashmiri red chili powder, a pinch of turmeric, little bit of masala powder. I'm going to make this into a fine paste first. I'm going to carefully mix all of this together to cover the paneer. Now I'm going to cover this tight and keep this in the fridge for at least 20 minutes so that it gets nice and juicy. It has been around 10 minutes. Let's check up on the sauce. Look how easy it is now to peel off the tomato skins. So I'm going to now peel off all these tomato skins. And then we will smash these tomatoes. Half a spoon of Kashmiri red chili powder and 1/4 spoon of normal red chili powder. A very important thing to add in your sauce will be a spoon of sugar. It depends on how much sweet you want the sugar, but don't skip on this because it does make a difference. I have added 2 small spoons of ketchup here. Now I'm going to cook it for another 2 minutes, and then the cooking part of the sauce is ready. We just have to blend this together and make it into a nice chunky paste. Here you go. Our pizza dough is nice and puffy at this time. But now we'll have to beat the crap out of this. So let's do that. Now I've floured the surface and I'm going to take out the dough. And we will actually have to knead this. Knead this until we get a smooth dough consistency. If you start feeling that your hand is sticking, make sure that you add a little bit more of the flour. My hands are all dirty, but this is the size of the pizza I'm gonna make. This is small, but that's all we require for the two of us. If you have the original oven the electric oven, then please go ahead and use a wooden tray. That would give a nice crust to your pizza. However, I'm using this. This works and does the trick as well. Add some rava at the bottom so that the pizza does not stick to the plate. Now I'm gonna stretch the dough as much as I can with my hands and then add it to the plate. From here, I'm using my fingers to push the dough towards the end of the plate. Now that is done, I'm going to cover this and keep it aside for just 10 minutes so that the gluten is rested, and then we will put in the toppings. The marinade has set on the paneer. I'm going to go ahead and fry this. I have some oil left over from the pizza sauce I made, so I'm using the same oil to fry these. A pizza topping can be anything from veggies to non-veg to pineapple as well. My favorite pizza topping is onions, bell peppers, either chicken or paneer, and jalapeno, pickled jalapeno. Without it, my pizza is totally empty. So here I already have my onions cut into thin strips, and I'm going to use a little bit of the red as well as the yellow bell pepper. Now these are sweeter than the green bell pepper you generally get. That is the reason why these are used mostly on pizza. I'm going to remove the seeds from inside the bell pepper. Now you can choose to keep them as is on the pizza, but I like to saute them a little bit before I place them as a topping on the pizza. I'm just adding all of this together with very little bit of oil and saute them for maybe like 2 or 3 minutes and then take them out. This is how the pizza sauce is going to look. So I've grinded my pizza sauce and I have kept it in such a way that it is a little chunky. I don't like making it very thin and fine, but it's totally up to you again. Now, as you can see, my oven is already getting ready. I've already kept it to preheat just like you would do on a normal oven. And I'll give it around 5 minutes on high flame so that the whole utensil is nice and hot. And once that is done, I'm gonna assemble my pizza and get to bake it. Let me show you guys my toppings. I am absolutely obsessed with the pickled jalapeno. I take it from a jar actually. You can choose to have it or not have it. It's totally up to you. Mozzarella cheese is absolutely required. I'm going to also add processed cheese, but just 1 cube. And here is my paneer, and here is the sauteed vegetables. This is going to be my pizza toppings. You can customize it as and how you require. After all, that is what is homemade pizza, right? Now I'm going to poke holes onto the dough so that it does not puff up when we are baking it. And since we've added the rava or the semolina at the bottom, it's not going to stick to the pan. Now let's assemble the toppings. Sauce first. I'm going to add in the mozzarella cheese. Of course, you can add in as much as cheese you require. I generally add a little bit more than usual because who doesn't like cheese on pizza? Now I'm adding the veggies. Next up, the paneer. jalapenos. And finally, I'm going to add in the rest of the mozzarella cheese I have. Why I do this is because it will melt down on top of the toppings, and also it gives a nice caramelized taste to the cheese. I've turned off the heat from high to medium, and now I'm going to put in the pizza. I can literally feel the heat, you guys. In goes the pizza. All the hard part of making the pizza is done, but it's kind of a fun process. I mean, who doesn't like to do some baking at home? So now that the pizza is in our oven, let's wait for at least 10 to 15 minutes. You will have to pick up the lid to see if the crust is becoming golden. And once it does, you can take off the pizza and it'll be ready for you to have. The sauce I made for this pizza today gives me 2 servings. So I've used already half of it, and the rest half, I'll be storing it in an airtight container in the fridge, and it goes about 2 weeks, but I generally finish it off in another week. Also, I've added a little spritz of red chili flakes and oregano on top of the pizza after I've put it, because I forgot. There you go, guys. My pizza is ready. I'm just taking it out of the so-called oven. You've got to be skilled for all this. Here, my pizza is ready and it's nice and warm. I've just cut a piece of it, and let's go ahead and taste it. Look at the crust. It's nice and golden at the bottom, and very spongy is the base. This is absolutely how I love my pizza. So that is it. My pizza is ready and I have a slice. Let me give it a taste test. Awesome. I'm telling you, it's awesome. The crust is so tasty. Oh my god, I like it. I'm telling you, ever since I've started making my own pizza at home, I've never wanted to go to Domino's or Pizza Hut. Domino's and Pizza Hut, who? I don't even know. Literally, give it a try, you guys. So if you guys don't have an oven at home, please invest on something like this. It comes handy because, I mean, who doesn't like to have a little bit of treat here and there? I really don't want to wait anymore. I'll have to share maybe a quarter with Naveen, or maybe a little bit more. He's looking at me, but yes, I absolutely love it. No matter if you're making it veg, non-veg, whatever, you can choose your own toppings. And at the end of the day, it's like a pizza overloaded. And I'm telling you, you don't even have to pay that much as you do when you go to a fast food chain and you don't even know how they make everything. So this is safe, yummy, and easy, isn't it? Give it a try. And if you do, please tag me on Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that bell notification button so that the next time I post a video, you do not miss it out. Until next time, bye. A little spritz of red chili flakes. I'm going to also add as it is. Also, you can leave it at the. I like to saute them